I recently took a trip, and when we flew back in, we had to taxi along the runway for a while, and I couldn't help but notice the whole time we were taxiing, we didn't pick up any black people. I find that racist. What a taxi driver says and what a taxi driver is thinking. You tell the taxi driver to take you to the corner of 26th and Olympic. The taxi driver says okay, but the taxi driver's thinking, I wonder if they still make Crystal Pepsi. And the answer is no. No, they do not. It's a well-known fact that before Americans went into space, communists were up there. Before communists went into space, we were both shooting monkeys up there. Which means monkeys have a high place in my book, in as much as they're the first beings to masturbate in space. But I wonder, who is the first being to masturbate in space while thinking about store mannequins? And were they thinking about the mannequins with only half a head down at the express, like I think about when I masturbate? This is my impression of an overly dramatic blind witness. I didn't see nothing, man! Nothing, man! I can't see, man! I used to work in West Hollywood, and I don't have a girlfriend, haven't had one for a while, so a lot of people ask me, dude, are you gay? And my answer is, no, I'm as straight as the day is long, so I'm a little gayer in the wintertime. Wink. Oh, I tell you, it's 2009, going on 2010. And I think it's time we stop making the colored pencils sit in the back of the box.
Wow.
I ate some alphabet soup, threw it all right up. I think my stomach was trying to tell me something, and that something was, Grfandepafringadishai. I read it. Oh, man. But, you know, I'm a big fan of the alphabet, so much so that when I do have kids, I'm going to have 26 of them and name each one after a letter in the alphabet. We'll have 20 strapping young men, 5 beautiful little girls, and then there will be Y. No one's going to know what Y is. But like I said, I don't have a girlfriend and I don't have any kids, but that does not stop me from wanting to hear the pitter-patter of little feet. That is why I live with 42 midgets. Sure, I pay like a fraction of rent, but I've gained 50 pounds from all the chocolate they make. Is it just me, or is something else going on in those Georgia O'Keeffe paintings other than just flowers? A rose by any other name would be Fred Gunderson of Peoria, Illinois.